Hey guys, today I want to help you save some money by talking about insurances to avoid. I'm going to go over some insurances that I really don't think you need to be paying for and help save some money for you to spend elsewhere. All right, so a lot of these insurances are assuming that you've kind of taken my advice on the other insurances that I believe you should have. One is health insurance. All right, so make sure you're properly insured. Make sure you don't have any crazy deductibles or out-of-pockets. So if you've got proper health insurance place, I think paying for cancer insurance is a waste of money. Your health insurance company should cover something like that, right? So if you've got good health insurance, it's typically going to cover your cancer treatments and things like that. So paying for cancer insurance, I believe, is an insurance that you can probably cut out. If you have proper life insurance in place, again, I believe that term insurance is the way to go. It's cheaper, it's a good way to get insurance for a lot of people. So if you've got a good term insurance in place and you're properly covered, I believe that mortgage life insurance is an unnecessary insurance to have. So mortgage life insurance is something that would come in place. It's really in place for the company that holds your mortgage on your house to protect them in case you die, right? So if you've got proper life insurance, that should be able to cover for your spouse that you've left behind, your family, to pay for that debt that you have. Other insurance I think you should avoid is AD&D, also known as accidental death and dismemberment. AD&D insurance, from my understanding, is very tough to actually come to fruition. All right, so let's say on the very small list of accidental deaths that they give you, that happens, you've only got about 30 days to redeem the policy or it goes away. So there's very strict restrictions on how to get the proceeds from that insurance, and I just think you can better use that money elsewhere. If you have a solid emergency fund, right? So you've got 3 to 6 months of living expenses saved in the bank. I don't believe you need to be paying for short-term disability insurance. I believe long-term disability insurance is very important, but once you've got that emergency fund built up, I think you can drop it. The idea is you're no longer living paycheck to paycheck, so if you're out of work for a couple weeks, so be it. You can afford it, you've got that money saved in the bank. I think you can cut out short-term disability insurance from your budget. And then lastly, once you retire, there's a couple insurances that I believe you can drop, which is any type of disability insurance and any type of life insurance above funeral and burial expenses. All right, so the idea behind disability and life insurance is to protect lost income. Once you're no longer working, there's no income to protect. Life insurance, other than maybe $10,000 to cover funeral and burial expenses, I believe is no longer necessary. And disability insurance for sure is no longer necessary because there's no employment to cover from that insurance. Let me know if you have questions and if you're thinking about getting one of these insurance companies, I'd be happy to talk through it with you. I simply am giving you my opinion. Others may disagree. But I'm just trying to save you guys money. Let me know if you have questions and any other topics you want me to cover. Soon I'm going to be going into estate planning. Fun stuff. See you then.